So these are the top four social media sites as of 2025. And yeah, Meta owns three of the four, with Facebook at the top of the list with a whopping 3 billion monthly active users. That's why I've recorded this short course on Facebook ads for 2025. You see, if you're running Facebook ads in 2025 the same way as you did last year, you're already behind. Meta just changed the rules, and these aren't minor tweaks. We're talking complete shifts in how things are built, optimized, and scaled. Whether you're a business owner, marketer, agency, or a business leader, this is the course for you. I'm talking about campaign structure overhauls, Advantage Plus, budget strategies, creative best practices, and how to avoid burning your budget in this age of Facebook ads. If you want to leave behind that is easy to come back to, I'd encourage you to download the HubSpot's Marketer Guide for Meta, Tactics for Facebook and Instagram, which is filled with examples of brands doing it right, from Headspace to Monday.com in the New York Times. And the best part, it's not going to cost you a cent. I've linked the free guide below. All right, let's dive in to Facebook and Meta ads. Let's start by talking about Meta's new campaign structure. Campaigns are no longer organized the way that they once were. It has changed. Everything has shifted. Advantage Plus shopping campaigns used to be a very simple, single ad set, clean interface that led to very strong results, but that experience is gone. Now you're dealing with multiple ad sets inside of Advantage Plus campaigns, hybrid budget options with both campaign level and ad set level toggles, a subtle but powerful shift in how Meta's bidding model actually works. You see, instead of grouping audiences and feeding them creative like we did before, Meta is now pushing creative to users, matching more aggressively on the individual level with their own AI and systems behind the hood. That means that creative testing is more important than ever before. And yes, the interface still kind of looks similar, but once you hit create campaign, everything changes. Meta now determines whether it's Advantage Plus based on your inputs, not by a toggle. In the past, when you set up a sales campaign inside of Ads Manager, you were explicitly asked, do you want to use manual campaign or Advantage Plus? You made the choice. You knew exactly what type of campaign you were building. Well, that choice is gone. In 2025, there is no Advantage Plus toggle. You aren't selecting it. You are actually activating it based on how you structure your campaigns. Meta has integrated Advantage Plus logic directly into the campaign creation workflow. So instead of choosing it, you trigger it by following specific setup criteria like broad targeting, optimized placements, campaign level budgets, and purchase as your conversion event. If you follow those signals, your campaign becomes Advantage Plus under the hood. You'll know you're in an Advantage Plus flow if you see subtle interface cues. Certain options are going to disappear, like custom audience controls for manual bidding fields. Campaign scoring starts nudging you toward best practices like the automated placement and 7-day click attribution. But that's not all. Say goodbye to existing customer budget caps. Before, you could say truly, only spend 10% of my budget on past customers. Now, that option is kind of gone. So what should you do? What should marketers, business owners, advertisers do? Well, you need to use custom audience exclusions. You can now exclude past purchasers or engaged audiences from your Advantage Plus campaigns. For example, for every brand that we work with, we integrate HubSpot directly into Meta so we can build high intent custom audiences just like this. One, engaged leads. These are the contacts who have visited your product pages, downloaded a resource, or opened multiple emails in the last 30 or 90 days. Sales qualified leads. These are people who are flagged by your sales team or automation systems as ready to buy. And finally, existing customers. Based on close won deals or purchase events synced directly from HubSpot into Meta or native integrations and custom workflows, you can see who is your customers. Once these segments are built and synced, you want to select the engaged audiences. These are again the warm leads, visited pages, open emails, click CTAs from the last 30 to 90 days, and existing customers. Purchasers who are tracked via HubSpot, the Metapixels, etc., typically 90 to 180 days. These audiences are critical to exclude from your top of funnel prospecting with the new Facebook Advantage Plus feature. We can retarget with specific post-purchase offers and get sales. Now, once those audiences are in place, you've set them all up, we're optimizing for purchases. not just add to cart or view content, Meta needs to know where the money is made. So set your budget at the campaign level unless you have a very niche use case. Meta's algorithm optimizes better with broad data inputs. So lean into it and use that as you move forward with Advantage Plus. Now, let's talk about another shift, the evolution of audience targeting. You can now build hybrid audiences inside of Advantage Plus campaigns. That means you can go broad. You can seed it with demographic signals. You can exclude specific segments like past purchasers, or you can even exclude an entire email list. Don't ignore suggested audience features, but don't rely on them solely. This is a mistake too many brands make. Always test exclusions to protect your spend. And if you're doing top of funnel prospecting, use exclusions to keep it pure. If you're testing narrow versus broad, run two separate campaigns, one that's 100% broad with exclusions, one that's interest-based with a very tight demo targeting. This is how it's done. Advantage Plus also has made huge announcements around placements. For the first time in forever, you can now select specific platforms that you want to run ads on. If you just want to show up on Facebook, Instagram, you can do that. If you exclusively want to show up on mobile or desktop, you can do that. There's inventory filters for expanded and moderate. And guess what? WhatsApp is announcing that they're allowing you to run ads too. Keep in mind though, expanded inventory is the new default. This includes all kinds of different content, some that might not exactly align with your brand, so you want to start with a test and expand later. When you're running Facebook or Meta ads, your Facebook video ads and image ads can appear selectively or across all of the following placements, depending on what placements work best for you. I'd suggest you test Facebook feed, Facebook Marketplace, Facebook Video Feeds, Facebook Right Column, Business Explorer, Messenger Inbox, Facebook Stories, Facebook Reels, Messenger Stories, Facebook In-Stream Videos, Overlay Ads on Reels, Facebook Search Results, Meta Audience Network, Native Banner and Institutional, Meta Audience Network, and Rewarded Videos. It's a lot, I know. That's why you should probably download the Master Meta Marketing Guide I've linked to in the description below, because it's filled with everything that you need to know about Meta ads. All right, now let's talk about my favorite subject, my favorite concept, and that is the creative strategy. We want to talk about the creative strategy and the campaign flow that you should be using on Meta. And I'd be lying to your face if I said that creativity doesn't matter in the age of AI. Wrong. Creative is everything now. Meta's machine learning is heavily optimized for creative to user fit. Here's a few quick wins that we think every brand should be considering in today's age. Broad targeting. You should be running 3 to 5 creative angles per ad set and rotate those 2 to 3 weeks. See if your customers are getting fatigued and then exclude the purchasers, run the winning campaigns and let your winners ride. Multiple ad sets are allowed, which gives you more agility. And AI makes it easier than ever to create multiple ads at scale. You can test hundreds of different ad campaigns and concepts and hooks and visuals and graphics. You can experiment with UGC style content, polish brand videos, experiment with vertical versus square, run the experiments, folks, heavy text, minimum text. All of these things are worth testing. Do not just see your competitors do something and say, we should do the same thing. Maybe you want to test having a clear benefit statement in the first 30 seconds. Maybe you want to incorporate visual proof, a demo, testimonials. All of these things need to come down to your strategy and your approach. Have call to actions that match your funnel stage. All of this goes into the way that you're thinking about your creative, your campaigns, and your approach. All right, let's talk about the last thing, the most important thing. Please, in 2025, 2026, I pray that you don't launch your campaigns and just pray. You have to remember to measure the data. Click-through rates, for example, you should be aiming for anywhere from 1.5 to 3%. Your return on ad spend, 2x or higher for scale. Frequency, if it's over 3, then refresh your creative. Conversion rates, 2 to 5% is a pretty solid range that I would aim for. And then you also want to know your break-even so you can understand your cost per lead, cost per acquisition, and things like that. So if you want to make this happen and make it work, then you need to install the Metapixel or Events Manager to connect to certain CMSs. My standard, my best practice is to always use 7-day click, 1-day view attribution window, and then let the results trickle in. All right, I want to summarize for you 2025 and beyond's playbook. Folks, embrace the new Advantage Plus structure. Don't fight it. Use campaign-level budgets for better optimization. Exclude audiences strategically instead of relying on budget caps. Test creative like your business depended on it, because at the end of the day, it kind of does. Watch your metrics weekly. Don't just set it and forget it. And I hope that you found this course valuable. And remember, don't do this alone. I've included a link in the description that goes deep into how brands like you can understand how to build a presence on Facebook, Instagram, the impact of paid, and how to measure performance with growth at the forefront of what you're trying to do. And if you're looking to keep learning more, smash that subscribe button, because HubSpot's always publishing great content on marketing all the time, and you don't want to miss it. I'm Ross Simmons. Thanks for listening, and I will see you on the internet.